Smartphones and tablets stole the gadget headlines in 2010 as the innovation spotlight turned away from consumer electronics and back to computing. Here's our look at the top gadgets of 2010. Probably the biggest buzz of the year was around tablets, and that's all thanks to the iPad. Unveiled in January and launched in April, the iPad has set the standard to match.
And we call it the iPad.
A string of competitors followed, from big names like NEC and Toshiba to smaller brands. All tried to capture sales while the tablet market was hot. Samsung's Galaxy Tab launched in the last few months, and more tablets are on the way. RIM's Playbook, unveiled earlier this year, will launch in early 2011.
Introducing the world's first professional tablet, the BlackBerry Playbook.
RIM is hoping to build on its enterprise computing strengths from the BlackBerry to sell the Playbook to businesses. The focus on tablets didn't mean that laptops were forgotten. We started 2010 at CES with Lenovo's IdeaPad U1. It looks like a regular laptop, but detach the screen and it becomes a tablet PC. The display portion has a second processor, battery, and Linux operating system. Another transforming machine was MSI's Sketchpad. Grab the keyboard and it flips to reveal a pen input pad. In this Acer Aspire 1, it's the software where the innovation lies. It uses the Android operating system as a quick booting OS and also includes Windows as the main OS. And right at the end of the year, Google showed off its CR48. The hardware isn't anything special, but it runs the company's Chrome OS, the first laptop to do so. But as in tablets, some of the biggest buzz in 2010 in laptops was around Apple. The company's MacBook Air just keeps getting thinner. The new model, just 1.7 centimeters deep, it has an all-aluminium body and looks great. 2010 was the year that ebook readers began to take off, thanks largely to declining prices and more competition. Amazon launched new Kindle readers, with the cheapest costing $139. A year earlier, the cheapest was $259. In response, competitors dropped prices and added new features. Barnes & Noble put color on its Nook device.
With Nook Color, Barnes & Noble has combined the functionality and convenience of a portable wireless tablet with the reader centricity of a dedicated e-reader.
And more color should be on the way. E-Ink, which makes the screens for most of the major e-readers, showed off its first color e-paper screen in November. It will appear first on an ebook reader from China's Hanwang technology next year. We still don't know when any of the major companies will be using it. In mobile, Apple stole some headlines with the iPhone 4, but didn't dominate the news in 2010. Android smartphones and Windows 7 were also much talked about. Microsoft unveiled its new phone OS in February, and the first handsets began appearing towards the end of 2010.
We wanted the Windows phone to be always delightful for you. Whether you were looking for a place to eat, reading mail, catching up with friends, or making a phone call.
At the heart of the user interface are themed hubs, which consolidate applications, services, and content. The People Hub, for example, aggregates phone calls, text messages, social media feeds, and Outlook email messages in a single view and updates them in real time. Launch devices came from Taiwan's HTC, Samsung, LG, and Dell. Google's ill-fated entry into the cell phone market seemed like a bad omen for Android in 2010. The Nexus One was both launched and phased out within the year, but things were better for other Android devices. Motorola's Droid series and Samsung's Galaxies were among phones that enjoyed good sales and helped push Android into a strong position in the cell phone market. The year kicked off with a big 3D push at CES. TVs with 3D functions were everywhere, but the buzz soon died. It seems people just don't want to watch TV wearing special glasses. In October, Toshiba offered a possible solution. The world's first 3D TV that doesn't require glasses, but it's expensive. A 12-inch model is $1,400, and a 20-inch set costs $2,900. And the technology? Well, it's still not quite perfect. Panasonic launched a 3D-capable camcorder. A lens adapter on the front enables the camera to capture 3D images side by side. There's some quality loss in 3D mode, but it should help solve a problem facing many 3D early adopters: the lack of content. And we end our gadget year in review with Fujifilm's Z700, a digital camera that can recognize dogs and cats. The camera can even snap a picture automatically when they look towards the camera lens. Too bad we couldn't test it on the real thing. And that's our review of the top gadgets of 2010. We'll have more gadget news right here in the first week of January when the Consumer Electronics Show takes place in Las Vegas, so keep watching for that. In Tokyo, I'm Martin Williams, IDG News Service.